Hey guys, happy Wednesday. Who's ready to paint some watermelons? Who's ready to paint some watermelons, guys? That's what we're going to be doing today. Painting some watermelons. That is, has been a very requested, craft on my craft and chat with Tracy. So I am so excited to be here with you today. And when you come onto the video, say hello. Maybe let me know where you're watching from. I just love to know and see where my community is watching from. If I'm live, there's a red live button up here in the top of the video. But if that red live button is not there, that means that you're watching on the replay. And I'm so glad that you are. I'm so glad that you're here. No matter if you're watching it now when I'm live or if you're watching it on the replay on Facebook or on YouTube, welcome to Country Charm by Tracy. I am Tracy and I love to share crafty ideas just like this watermelon. And that's what we're going to be doing today. Hi, Erin. Hi, Amy. Hi, Grace. Hi, Brenda. Grace is watching from Texas. I am also in Texas in a little town called Brenham. We're home for Bluebell ice cream. And so, hey, Tanya. Thanks, Brenda, for sprinkling. Sprinkling, it, guys, is just a free way to help us crafters. It's just by, sprinkling just means to like spread the charm, on your personal page, or if there's like free groups that, or public groups that allow, sharing of the, I shouldn't say that word. I don't know why. FB doesn't like us to say that. Hello, Misty. Hey, Nicole. Hey, Gina and Laura and Mary. I am so glad that y'all are here. Tanya's watching from Central Arkansas. Laura is from Alabama. Nicole's in North Texas. And I know Misty, the crafty farmer, she's up in Waxahachie. I just love saying that name. Anyway, so guys, I almost, I was like, am I not supposed to go live today? Because things just kept happening. And so I had all of my, information in the description and, almost hit the go live button. And it like, FB totally shut off. I'm like, I had to like get back on the app and it's like, okay, what's going on? We're not going to have this. Thanks, Pam. Pam says she loves watching me create. Gina is watching from Louisiana. Dorinda is in Alabama as well. Christine, hey to you too. Susan is watching from Kentucky. Welcome, 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 guys. Thank you so very much for being here. Like I said, we're going to be painting some watermelons. I said this morning because I couldn't decide if I wanted to paint watermelons or if I wanted to do the Uncle Sam. I am going to do a patriotic Uncle Sam. And so I'll share that for another time. Anyway, guys, so this is where we're going to be painting one of these. And then also, I'm going to share, how I painted this and how I made my little slices, guys. I'm not on a time schedule today, so I'm going to, do it as long as it takes to create it. I'm going to do some hand lettering. This is one that I made a couple of years ago that I use like for a reference kind of thing, but I'm going to be doing some hand lettering. And then I'm also going to show you how I paint my little slices. I just kind of stick with the same, method, same colors, all of that stuff, because it's just my go-to. It's just what I do with them. Anyway, so I'm so glad that y'all are watching today's Craft and Chat with Tracy. Hello, Miss Rose, you sweet lady. She's from watching from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Amy is in Wisconsin. Crafty Farmer, she is in the car line getting the kiddos. Well, God bless you. I'm so thankful that I don't have to do that anymore. I'm so glad I don't have to do that. Get in the car line. My husband picks up my, now that my son is finished with spring football, he gets picked up after school. And so he's 15. So he like walks, you know, down the road, and he's, you know, dad pulls in the parking lot, so I don't have to go through the car lot and that kind of thing. Anyway, hello, Miss Donna, and Amy. Thank y'all for being here. All right. So, also, if I reference anything as far as my link tree, that is where, that's kind of like my hub of all my links and everything, is, I think I have it pinned. Maybe I didn't. Maybe it didn't pin. Gosh darn it. I tell you, I did. I had everything like ready to go, and FB just like shut me out. So I had to like start all over, reopen the app, re-put in my information. Anyway, so I wanted to put my link. It's kind of like the place that you can, like if I reference anything. And so it just has all of my information as far as, because if the reason that I like to share that with y'all is because a lot of the times when I create or paint, or you know, like especially I'm going to be using one of these flags and you from the Dollar Tree, and if you can't find it, I have a pattern that if you want to draw it, you know, so in my link tree there is a free patterns. I have a page that I have all of my patterns and all of my like different fonts that I like to use and all of that stuff. Hey, Susie. Susie's watching from Denmark. Well, hello from Texas, USA. Hello, Miss Linda, my sweet friend. I haven't talked to you in like forever. Miss Linda is FaithChick777 on YouTube, and she is the one, guys, that I tell y'all that I use the rusty, how to rust small metals. I always refer to her video. So hello and welcome. Hi, Tammy, Joyce. Okay. All right, guys. I could just like talk to y'all all day. So thank you so much. And also, FB doesn't show comments all the time, so I'm not ignoring you. If you have a comment or have a question of something that I'm doing that I'm not quite clear, leave me a comment, and I promise I go back and I, you know, try to answer. Or and I invite any of my crafty friend or any of my friends that are here, please feel free to answer anyone's question. I greatly appreciate it, because I'm, like I said, I'm by myself. Last time I had a troll and I had to get them, had to zap them. So y'all call that to my attention if we get something like that too. Oh, you're welcome, sweet Linda. I just love everything that you do. We need to do another collab on YouTube. It's been a long time since we've done that. All right. Okay. So let me tell you what we're going to do. We're going to be doing some watermelons, and this is what I did a couple of years ago. And guys, this is what I used. I used one of these. Aren't they called flags? Correct me if I'm wrong, but I had got, you know, this one I got from the Dollar Tree. Now, this one has the rounded edge. Now, the last few years, they've had these that have the scalloped edge. And that's what I used for this one, the scalloped edge, like that. And so, no matter which one you use, you know, they turn out really cute. So, I'm just saying, this is how it looks with the rounded edge. And then today, we're going to use one that has the scalloped edge. All right. Okay, good deal. Oh, Paula, thank you. I'm so glad that you are here. All right. So, as I mentioned, if you can't, because I don't know, I've had these flags for a couple of years, like I've stocked up on them, especially like when they were like clearing them out for the season and stuff. And so I had stocked up on them. That's what you can see right here. Because I also was going to be doing some pumpkin pie slices in the fall. So I'm like, let me get some of those, you know, because that's what I do. But then I never did the pumpkin pie. So I may do that this year. Anyway, but won't that look cute? Little pumpkin pie in the little, you know, white with the, I could do like some caulking or some faux snow or something for the icing. Oh my goodness, how cute. Okay. All right, so now that we got all of that out of the way, that's what I'm using, is one of these scalloped edges. And guys, what I did is to take off the paper. It was, some of them, they're easier than others. Now this one, I didn't even worry about because I think this was one of the first ones that I did, and maybe that's why I keep it, because I'm like, oh yes, I want to use that one for a reference. But what I do is just took my Cricut spatula or a knife or something to get up underneath there. Now, sometimes the paper came off, some came off a little bit easier than the other ones. So anyway, it is what it is. Thank you so much, Nicole, for sprinkling. Crafty Farmers, yes, Misty, hit up the Dollar Tree. I don't know if they have, yeah, they have their 4th of July stuff out. But anyway, these are just so cute. You could just make so many different things. And then a couple of years ago, I had made a turkey feathers using one of these scalloped ones as well. I don't know who remembers that, but I had turned it over and made the turkey. Oh my goodness, I did that on live. It's on my page as well as on my Facebook. I mean, on my YouTube. All right. So guys, I'm gonna go ahead and bend you down so that I can show you my space, and then show you what we're going to do to create these cute country watermelons. All right. So, like I said, this is one like for reference. And so I took off the paper, but I'm going to use this side of it. And what I did to fill the holes, I just used my spackle from the Dollar Tree. Hi, Debbie from Kansas. Hi, Jennifer. So glad that y'all are here. Now, this one is left over from probably last year because I have been painting these watermelon wedges for a couple of years because I have been putting them on wreaths. And so some of you that follow me, you know that I design wreaths. I work part-time for a local business. And so they actually have an event coming up June 23rd, 24th, and 25th. It is their summer kind of customer appreciation. And so I know what that means. I need to get some wreaths and stuff ready for them to have for the event. And so I am diligently trying to get some summer things done. I mean, I'm lucky, I'm blessed, but because she has like a little waiting list, and like when I take them some wreaths, she calls and so they don't even hit the floor, you know? And so I'm like, gosh, I need to get busy and get some more summer wreaths done. All right, guys. So I'm going to paint one of these. And then now this is what I did to paint the wedges. Not paint the wedges, but cut the wedges. So I just took the same one, just like this. And what I did is I just took my box blade and just scored it a couple of times. Well, actually more than a couple. I just used my mat and I scored in probably about 5 or 6 times. And depending on the pressure will depend on how many times you need to score it. And I just used my box blade. I got this from the Dollar Tree. You can get box blades anywhere, you know, Home Improvement, Lowe's, Home Depot, Walmart, anywhere like that. Anyway, and so then these are my wedges. And so it has the little scalloped end and or edge rather, and so it just looks so cute. All right, so that is what we're going to be doing today. All right, so usually what I do is I just take my pencil and just kind of sketch it out. I go probably about an inch in, you know, for the rind. Yep. And so I just kind of go about an inch in. Can't talk today. So I just take my pencil and just kind of sketch it out. And if I get off a little, I try to encourage, you know, my community, because there's a lot of people. I do wreaths, I do painting, I do, you know, just different crafts, home decor, that kind of thing. And so I know that there are a lot of people that follow me, maybe for different reasons. I'm a true craft junkie, guys. I'm a true craft junkie, and I just love to do all kind of crafts. I get bored with the same, doing the same thing. So Jennifer says she's teaching herself to paint. I'm so glad that you caught me too, Jennifer, because that's what I did. I was determined to learn how to paint, and so that's what I did. I, you know, found my, some people that I like their painting style, and so I just kind of started following them, and you know, just kind of try to figure out what they did. I just followed along. Anyway, so I wanted to show y'all on this. I think everyone kind of knows how to put this spackling in, but if this is your first time seeing it, you can get this spackling at Dollar Tree in the hardware section, or you can get it maybe at, you know, Walmart, other, like, you know, Lowe's, Home Depot, that kind of thing. Anyway, and it just kind of fill the holes, on these signs, because it does come like with a hanger, and, yeah, it does. It comes with jute. It comes, like, they come with a jute hanger. And so I just take that off. And so then, since I want to use these for my watermelons, I don't want that hole in there. So I just cover it up, or just fill it with some spackling. All right. So then we're going to put it, and it actually doesn't take very long at all to dry. So then now I'm gonna just kind of sketch out a little bit for the green, so that I can paint. Oops, kind of got off a little bit. All right. And so that's what I do. I try to, you know, kind of paint, you know, like whatever I'm doing. I kind of try to multitask and paint quite a few at the same time. Kind of take them out and, you know, do that kind of thing. All right. So I'm going to start with Holly Green. And this is just the color that I like my rind to be. And so this is just an Americana paint color called Holly Green. But, you know, every paint company has their own name. I couldn't think of what I was saying. Name for their paints. So anyway, and then I'm just taking like a 1-inch brush. Since I have a 1-inch border, I just kind of feel like I can control it a little bit better. And so, you know, every painter, every creator, every, you know, designer, everybody has to find their own way, what tools work best for them, what shortcuts work best for them. And so, this is just, I appreciate y'all being here, spending some of your afternoon with me. And, you know, this is my therapy. I just love crafting. I love painting. I love just working with ribbon. And, you know, if you haven't heard my story, the gift shop that I designed the wreaths for, they contacted me and asked me back in 2015, I think, 2016, something like that. They had a request for some handmade wreaths, and so they reached out to me and asked if I would be interested. And so I thought it was just going to be, you know, for, oh, sure, I can make a few. Well, then while I was doing it, I was really trying to ramp up my YouTube channel, and so I said, well, I'll film it as I make my wreath, you know. And that was when handmade wreaths were really, really getting popular. And so, anyway, so as I made the wreaths, I would just film it. Well, now a lot of people want the wreaths. And so sometimes I don't get to film. I think I may have got that a little bit too wide, but that's all right. I will figure that up. Figure it out, rather. And so sometimes I don't get to film every single wreath video because I have to, you know, get them out so quickly. And sometimes it just takes a while to film and, you know, edit and upload and all of that good stuff. So I'm just using holly green for my rind. And I'm not too particular if I have one side thicker than the other side. I just kind of get that on there. Anyway. Baby wipes are one of my favorite crafting tools. I just changed my paper today because the other one I have been working and you know, getting stuff out. And so I was like, it was just horrible. So I said, let me change this paper. All right. So then now we're going to paint this one. And you know, like depending on what you're going to do, but these are very good size, and I mean these are what make great door hangers. I'm actually going to be doing some hand lettering on it today. But even if you didn't want a hand letter, or you could use your Cricut, you could use stickers, you know, any kind of saying that you would like. Watermelons are so popular in the summer. And if anybody's saying anything, I don't know. I haven't seen any more comments, so hope things are working fine. Like I said, when I hit the live button to go live on Facebook, FB shut me down. I'm like, nope, get behind me, Satan. Not today. We are not going to do that today. All right. So I'm just taking my 1-inch flat paintbrush and just going around. I kind of sketched it out with my pencil so that I could, you know, kind of have like a little pattern to go by. So our kids, well, my son is a freshman in high school, and then I have a grandson. He's a first grade. And so this is actually the last few days of school. They get out of school on Friday. And so beginning next week, my world is going to be totally different because they're both going to be here. And I'm like, you know, because even though I did, if you don't know, I retired from my day job last summer. I can't believe it's going to be a year. August the 1st or July 31st was my last day. I retired as a state of Texas employee. And so I had 32 and a half years. And so God has just given me all of these gifts, and He has allowed me to be able to, you know, share them with so many friends. And so this is my job. And you know, sometimes even though my family says they understand, my grandson's like, well, Fanny, you just craft, you don't work anymore. I'm like, I know, but that is my job. I craft, that's my job. I work, I do videos, I do crafts, I do wreaths, you know. So it's just funny how they interpret. So I mean, because I don't work, I don't go to another place, and you know, outside of the home. So then they think, well, you don't work, you just do crafts. I'm like, yeah, but I actually do work. Oh, thank you, Brenda. Thank you, sweet friend. Hello, Susie from Denmark. The color, you missed the color green, Brenda. Holly green. That's the color that I'm using. It's an Americana paint color. Holly green is what I'm using. And so I don't know if you saw This is what I'm using. I started with, this is one of the flags from Dollar Tree in the 4th of July patriotic section. I do, friends, I do appreciate y'all spreading the charm, sprinkling with anybody who may like, you know, this style of crafting, or if you want to, you know, have it on your like personal page so you can refer back to it, maybe paint along with me. You can fast forward, you can, you know, stop if you know, you didn't quite catch what I said in my Texas twang. Sometimes I, you know, been doing things for so long and I'm like, did I forget to say what I was doing? So anyway, I do try to go back and answer any questions or anything that I may have missed. I'd be happy to do that. Miss Brenda says she's happy she's a hoarder because she has one. Girl, you are speaking my language. You are speaking my language. And I am very messy today. That's okay. That's why I cover my table with this brown paper. I like this brown. I like the width of this brown paper. It's in the kids section. Is it Playscape? I think it's in the it looks like Vacation Bible School stuff, but they have brown and they have white. And so I just like it. I like the width of it. And so that's what I use to cover my my table. Now I had covered my table with I got some from Home Depot, but it's wider than my table, and so I have to fight with it. And I'm like, yeah, I don't like that. You know, if I have to fight with it and stuff. All right, so Misty is saying, I need you to give me some YouTube advice sometime. Absolutely. I will be happy to share anything that I have learned. YouTube is where I got my start. That was a long time ago before Facebook even thought about live video and all of that good stuff. All right, now what I'm using is, this is also Americana. This is just my preference. This is primary red. And so I always get the big bottles when I can because I go through so much paint. Anyway, so then that is what is going to be the red part of my watermelon. And these little boards from Dollar Tree, some of them are, I find, are a little bit more porous than others. Like some of them soak up the paint, like they just soak it up and I have to put two or three coats. But this one is pretty good. It's covering very well. Hi, Crystal. Hi, Shelly. So glad that y'all are coming on, guys. If I'm live, if I'm still live, there's a red live button at the top. If I'm not, that means you're watching on the replay, and I'm so glad that you're here because the majority of my friends do watch later on the replay, as well as I upload to my YouTube channel. So that is where the majority of my friends do watch, on YouTube and also on the replay, because I know people, everyone's busy. Busy. Anyway, so this will be my first summer to, you know, be with my grandson like full time. And so, I mean, I'm looking forward to it. You know, he's 7, he'll be 8 in June. And so, you know, he's at the age where, you know, he's a busy little boy. Busy. And so, my grandma name is Fanny, and short for Fanny Pack. There's a story that goes along with that. It was a joke between my friends at work. And it was like a throwback Thursday, and I had a fanny pack on because my son was 2 at the time, and I wanted him to wear his fanny pack that he had gotten for, we were going to the zoo. And I wanted him to wear his fanny pack. He had just, they had vacation Bible school at his little daycare. And I wanted him to wear his fanny pack so he could put his hand sanitizer in it. So I pulled my old fanny pack out and wore my fanny pack to the zoo, you know, because you do what you got to do for your kids. You know what I'm saying? And so I was a throwback Thursday. And my friends at work had got a hold of that picture and just, you know, didn't let me hear the end of it, you know, making fun of me. It was all in fun. It was all in fun. Anyway, so then, you know, when my son, when my grandson came to live with us, you know, I needed a grandma name because we already had a grandma. We already had Nanny. We already had Nana. We had, and I really wasn't a Gigi. And so I'm just painting this up, just with the red. I'm just using this is probably a 2-inch brush, I guess. And you can get these at Walmart, I think. Oop, I got some green. I mean, I got some red on there, but that's all right because we're going to go back and just go over it. So it's just so interesting to hear, you know, different names that grandkids call their grandparents. Anyway, so when I was trying to come up with the name, because I didn't want to be called Grandma. I'm sorry. I did, no offense to anyone that's called Grandma, but I had, my grandmas were grandmas and they were old in my eyes, rest in peace, you know, but I was like, no, I don't want to be called Grandma. So now when I look back, I'm like, you silly girl, it would be okay, you know, but anyway, so he calls me Fanny because my friends at work gave me that that nickname. Anyway, so then I just kind of let it dry up. I like to do a whole bunch of these at one time. Hi, Kelly. Thank you so much for spreading the charm. Hi, Lisa, watching from California. Brenda says painting is so therapeutic. Yes, ma'am. I love it. I love to paint, and I love the whimsical, you know, look, love the whimsical paint and all of that good stuff. So I'm just using my heat tool to dry up because I think I'm going to go ahead and give this another coat of paint. So I'm so thankful that y'all are spending a little bit of time with me today. No matter if you're watching now or if you're watching later on the replay, if you're watching the video after it's done, I do greatly appreciate. For the green, I'm using Holly Green. This is Americana paint color. It's just kind of, you know, like, always reminds me of a Christmas green. So anyway, I just give this another coat. Oops. Anyway, so I'm going to have my grandson, and so I'm like, you are not going to be just watching TV all summer. You're not going to be playing on the iPad. You're not going to be doing all that stuff. So I'm trying to think of some different things. But then, you know, with the gas prices so crazy the way they are, it's not like you can just, you know, get in the car. You have to like plan the trips and that kind of thing. Alrighty. So this is how our watermelons are looking so far. And if you're just tuning in, I'm using one of these flags from the Dollar Tree. I'm thinking maybe other places have it too, but these are just the ones I got from the Dollar Tree that has the has the little scallops on it. So I don't know. I really haven't looked, at the Dollar Tree. To be honest with you, ever since they went up to $1.25, hi, Kenita. Hi, Kelly from Indiana. Since they went up to $1.25, I'm very selective of what what I get. I don't know if y'all feel that way too, but I'm like, yeah, I don't need anything. I don't need to go to Dollar Tree. So I do know, now there are certain things that I do like to get, like when they have their, their new seasonal stuff out and that kind of thing. I do like to go in and see, kind of some of the stuff, like newer stuff. Alrighty. And for the red, I'm just using primary red. It's just a really bright red, and I like to use that. Donna says, yes, that quarter changes her mind, and it does me too, girlfriend. I'm like, yeah, I don't need that. Because I think the last time I was in there, I forget what I got. And it was like, I think seven things. And it was like $10 and something. And I'm like, mm-mm. I could figure in my head if I got 15 things, it was going to be, this price. If I got, 10 things, or if I got 30 things, you kind of like figure it in your head. But it's kind of like, you go and you get seven things and they're like $10 and something. I'm like, what? I didn't get that much, So, I don't know. Just for me, it really does make a difference. And also, and it probably is because in the back of my mind, I'm like, you don't need that because you have all of this other stuff that you need to use up. Brenda says she is more careful at what she grabs. Me too, girlfriend. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. So I am just giving this its last coat of paint. And we're going to dry this up. And then we're going to do the fun part by decorating. Decorating. Brenda says she can't figure in her head anymore. You're right. You can't figure in your head anymore. You got to go. Because like if you get seven things, it's going to be $7 plus the tax. But if it's $125, it's seven. You're like, wait a minute. How does that come to $10, So, I know it's all a mind thing. It really is a mind thing. So, I'm just drying this up so that I can, do the fun part, do all of the doodling and embellishing and all of that stuff, because that's what I like to do. Now, later, once the video is over, if there's no longer a red live button up at the top, you'll be able to fast forward or rewind to see if it's something that I did that you didn't catch. Oh, Debbie, you're sweet. Debbie says she loves everything I do. I do appreciate it, guys, for y'all watching, because if nobody watched, I wouldn't need to do this, This is my therapy. This is what I love to do. And, okay, let me see what I want to do next. All right. So then what I like to do is add some dimension to my, projects just to give it, I like dimension and I like depth. And so, I'm just going to use some black paint. This is just black acrylic paint. And, then, yeah, if y'all follow me for a while, y'all have seen me do this, but to do some shading, I just put a cup of clean water, or I just put, not a cup, just get a cup, and I have clean water, and then I just have some black paint, and then I have a paper towel, and just use some black paint. Erin says, your doodles and embellishments are her favorite parts of my design. Thank you, Erin. I do appreciate that. And I do appreciate anyone who says that. I'm just using, this is a number 12 flat paintbrush, guys, of my in my favorite set of paintbrushes, or a number. It's about a half of an inch is what it is. And I'm just saying that for reference because some people say that that really helps them just by, you know, knowing what size of brush I'm using. All right. So then I just like to add some, like I said, depth and dimension to my projects. And so I dip half of my brush in paint, the other half in clean water. And then I blend it here on a paper towel, and I just like to use those shop towels that, you know, you can get from Walmart or any automotive shop. And I always, one of my sayings is the beauty is in the details. And so, excuse me. We did have some rain last night. Thank you, Jesus, for the glorious rain. And so, man, I woke up this morning and my allergies were out of this world. And I was, I don't know, I just felt, well, you know, with the events of yesterday, what happened in Texas and all that stuff. And so, see, I got a little bit thick right there. So I'm going to show y'all real quick how I fixed that. But, you know, sometimes I may need to kind of like start over, wash out my brush or rinse it out rather, and just kind of go back and forth. And my painting projects are not perfect. And so I just kind of just go around. I have just found, you know, just different things that work best for me. And so you can see that. So I got a little thick right there. So then when that happens, what I do is just take some of that green paint and just kind of blend it in. Anyway, so my heart was extremely heavy, you know, this morning, extremely heavy. And so, and then with the allergies and all that stuff, I'm like, oh, it's Wednesday. I gotta go live, do some craft and chat. Kanifa, I have it pinned in my link tree, in the pinned comment. If you click on my link tree, that my Amazon shop is listed in there. All of my favorite links are in there. So now you can see, you know, why I just like the dimension or like the depth of it. This one's not done, and this one I add the black to it. And so also right here, I got a little bit off there. So I'll just take some of that green paint and just kind of blend it in just like that. And so that's why I just am. Brenda says they are under a tornado warning. Now, Brenda, you're in Mississippi, correct? You're in Mississippi, sweet friend. All right. Well, God's blessings for all of y'all in those paths. Those are not fun at all. Okay, Brenda's in Mississippi, and she says they're under a tornado warning or a warning. Oh, wow. Okay. Warning. Oops. Sometimes I don't pay attention, and then I dip the other side of my brush in the paint, but I only want one side of my brush in the paint, and then I put it in the water, and then I blend on a paper towel. And so, you know, I just like to, for especially for my watermelons, I will do black. Sometimes I shade with white. It just really kind of depends on what I'm doing, as well as, you know, what kind of look I'm wanting. So then I just go along the edges and do that. So, you know, hand painting, hand lettering is probably, it's very popular on my channel, on my page. And, you know, God has just given me the gifts and also the patience, because I wanted to learn how to paint like this. And, so, you know, he and I had some conversations over the years, and, I'm like, Lord, I really, really want to learn how to paint. And so there is a lot more painters now than, it was when I was trying to learn how to paint and that kind of thing. And so everybody has to find their own style, their own, you know, look that they're going for. And so I, you know, on our Facebook feed and also on our YouTube, depending on who we're subscribed to or who we're like the pages and stuff, will kind of depend on what comes up on our feeds and stuff. And you know, I follow quite a few painters, and you know, I'm like, I try not to be judgmental when people are just starting out, or you know, everyone is a little different, and what they do. God has just made us the way we are. And see, I got that one a little bit thicker, but that's okay, because it's just gonna add some character to it. Yes, Brenda says, what huge difference shading makes. It really does. So see, you can see here, here's one. And then here's one. See, you know, this one's shaded with black, and then this one's not. And so depending on what look you as the creator are going for, will depend on what colors you use, or how thick you put it on, or how, you know, how you go around and, you know, go around that. I just really feel that it just really adds so much to a painted project, any project. And so I'm all about the distressing, I'm all about the shading and all of that stuff. Thanks, Casey. All right. They're not perfect. I only say that because I don't want anyone to think I can't do it because it's not going to be perfect. It doesn't have to be perfect. Look, I got off right there. It's okay. It was really okay. That, because I'm going to put some, all kind of stuff on it. So it's not even going to worry about it. See, I got off right there too. That might be a little bit thicker. So once I finish, then I'll go back and go, yeah, I need to kind of blend that in a bit. So I only want to, tell you that to encourage you. That you can do it too. You can do it. Now, my grandson, who is 7, he's 8. He'll be 8 in June coming up. He's like, well, Fanny, we can craft. We can craft. And I'm like, okay. So we may be doing some crafts and stuff together. I don't know. I may have to figure out some crafts to do with him, but I don't know. Sometimes I just feel the older I get, I don't have the patience when it comes to you know, the little kids. Oh, God bless them. God bless them. All right. So then let me think what I want to do next. Okay. So then this is the one that I'm going to use next. This is called Citron Green. C-I-T-R-O-N, green. That's this color right here. That's this one right here. Citron green. Maybe that's what it is. Anyway, sometimes I just go and I look at the paints and I'm like, I don't have this color. So I get that one. Anyway, so let me get a new plate. Because I'll be picking up red and black and green and all that stuff. Anyway, all right. So then for the, like lines for my watermelon, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my fan brush. This is one of my favorite brushes. You have seen me use this, before. I also have this linked in my Amazon shop if it's something that you're interested in. But you can get fan brushes anywhere. But this one is my favorite. Like, this one I got at the Hobby Lobby or Michael's. And it's a little bit thicker than this one. I just like this one. And like I said, it is linked in my Amazon store, which is in my link tree. I have it pinned in the comments. All right. So what I do is it kind of like has the bristles where I don't want them to be clumpy. So I just take like about, not even quite half, maybe a quarter of it. And I just dip it in this citron green. This is the color I'm using, guys. And so I just do like this. I kind of do like a swoosh, not really a whole line, just a swoosh. And see how that just really pops against these two colors together. And that's just kind of the colors of watermelon that I'm doing. There we go, just like that. So as you can see, just by adding that, that really makes a difference. And, you know, if the painter, if you don't like that, if you're watching and you're like, yeah, I don't like that, use whatever you want or leave them off, that kind of thing. But I don't know. I just love that. So, I'm going to be, the gift shop that I designed for, that I do the wreaths for, they're having a summer, kind of like their summer, customer appreciation, as well as, their summer sale. And it's June 23rd, 24th, 25th of 2022. And they're going to have like a luau party and all of that stuff. It is the gift shop I designed for is Select Furnishings in Brenham, Texas. And so some friends like that are near, they're like, I'm going to come, you know? And anyway, they're going to have different things every day just for customer appreciation and summer. It's been a few years since they've done a summer sale. I mean, a summer luau party, customer appreciation. Anyway, so this is how our little watermelon, I know Joyce said it's coming to life. Brenda says she loves the colors. We started when he was 3. Oh, also. Oh, Marcy says she's been crafting with her oldest since he was six, and still checks. Yes. He still checks her patience. Yes, I know. Anyway, so here is how our little watermelon slices are looking, guys. I hope that y'all are enjoying it, as much as I am. And so, I'm going to be putting these on a wreath. I'm going to do some hand lettering on that. And so these probably, you know, these will be watermelon slices. And if you missed it, guys, this is what I'm using. One of these flag pennant things from the Dollar Tree or wherever else you can find them. So I'm just using my heat tool to dry this up as much as I can. And then we're going to be putting our embellishments on there as well. All right. Okay, let's see here. Now, I'm going to write Sweet Summer on here, but I'm going to go ahead and do these right fast. So, for my like seeds, what I like to do is I like to start out with my black Sharpie marker, and I kind of draw them on, and they're not perfect. Some of them are bigger than others, and I just draw it with my black Sharpie marker first. I don't know, it's just I don't even make sure that it's covered all the way, like the oval or almond shape or whatever. And then I go back over it with paint. Thank you, Linda. Linda says it looks spectacular. Thank you, sweet friend. So I kind of shoot for like the oval almond shape, but yeah, that don't always work out. Anyway, so I will go back and I will put, fill them in further with the black paint. You know, I don't know. You as crafters, it's like, you know, you have certain steps that you do. This is like one of those precepts that I do. I just start with black Sharpie marker and then I go back and fill it in further with my black paint. All right. Sometimes I'm like, why do you do that? Hey, Ashley, I haven't seen you in forever, girl. How you doing? I just love that we can connect, you know, on all of our social medias, you know, just with friends. And I see so many friends, you know, names that follow me on all the little different platforms. And sometimes I like to use a round brush, and sometimes I can't find it right off the bat, so I have to really look for it. So then now, guys, what I'm using, let me see what color, number one. This is a number one round paintbrush. It's in that paint brush set that I like. And let me see if I have another. Oh, yeah, I do. I can only find these on Amazon now. This is what the set looks like that I like to use. It has all of these brushes in it. These are just my favorite. I just love it. That's why you always see me using these. And so I also, like on the back of it, it also has all of the different widths and sizes and all of that. And so also in my link tree, there is a paintbrush chart that I have broken down all of those paintbrushes, and I've said what I use what brush for, you know, in that. Anyway, so then now I'm just taking that round, number one round paintbrush, and just going and filling in the holes. And so just by adding that, I don't know, it just gives me, I guess, the confidence. Because let me tell you, I have tried doing, for myself, I have tried doing seeds without doing the black Sharpie marker. And I'm like, oh my goodness, I got it way too big. Or, oh my goodness, that looks so horrible. So like I can see that that seed is bigger than that one. But I'm okay with it because sometimes some seeds are a little bit bigger than others. And my stuff is not perfect. I am so glad to see you too. Oh, that's wonderful. I'm so glad you're doing good. Thanks, Mandy. Mandy says this is adorable. So also, if you like, I am going to be using these for some wreaths, but I also have used some of these. I put them in my dough bowl and use them for, like, you know, my dough bowl filler, like just different decorations with my primitive country, like potpourri and stuff like that. And had just put some of these little wedges in there just to decorate for the summer season. It would be really cute to put on a shelf. You can also, you know, if you want to set them up or, you know, put something behind it, that would be great little tiered tray, you know, decorations, just cute embellishments for, you know, put it on a door hanger, just put it on, you know, so many different things. And like I said, I had bought quite a few of those patriotic flags. And let me show you that real quick. If someone's new popped on, this is what I'm using. I use one of these. I just cut them into slices like that for these right here. And then this one I painted up just, you know, as it was, I took off the back part of it, took off all that paper, And anyway, I'm going to be putting these on wreaths only because I do design wreaths for a local business, and they are having their summer customer appreciation. The store is called Select Furnishings in Brenham, Texas. And I share that with you because, you know, I get questions, I'll get private messages about buying my wreaths. And actually, I'm not quite sure if I would do wreaths if the gift shop wouldn't sell them. So I don't know. I love to do this kind of stuff. You know, I love to paint. I like to do wreaths. Don't get me wrong. It has grown on me. All right. So I'm going to put these to the side and kind of let those dry. So guys, this is how our little watermelon wedges are looking. And so, you know, as you can see, they just come to life with all of the different layering and that kind of thing. And so, all right. So then now I am going to use, this is a 1/4 inch flat paint brush, and we're going to be doing some hand lettering on this one. I'm going to write Sweet Summer, and so I'm just going to use some white acrylic paint on there like that, and so just put some of this white paint here, and I do like to you do my happy dots. And so as I encourage my community is to kind of air draw it, how so that way you kind of know the placement. Okay. All right. So if you're not comfortable in writing with a paintbrush, you can always cut something out if you have a die cutting machine like a Cricut or a Silhouette or something like that. You could use stickers. Learning to paint with a paintbrush, I had to teach myself, you know, and I learned by watching other people just like this. And then also, which you have heard me say before, is, you know, I have the, in my link tree, there is, I have a collection of free fonts that have dots on them that I have found and that you can download and like on your computer, and you can practice. You can maybe, you know, type out some sort of words, and you can, you know, trace it with graphite paper or tracing paper. And I got a little off, like I should have started up here a little bit more, but that is okay. It is going to be just fine. And so then if any of it's a little bit transparent, you know, where it needs to be thickened up a little, I'll go back over it. And so I love to put dots on the ends of my letters. It's just kind of one of my signatures of what I like to do. And sometimes I will use the end of a paintbrush. Sometimes I will use the actual paintbrush itself. So let me see if I can. Sometimes when I use the actual paintbrush, it takes just a little bit longer because I'm, you know, trying to form my circles. And like I said, defont.com, there's other places that have fonts that are free, like for personal use, that kind of thing. And so, you know, you can download them and you can, you know, print out just different things that you would like to do. And you can just practice and just have all kind of fun sayings and just different letters, lettering and that kind of thing. I don't know. I just more of a printed. I never really got into the calligraphy or the written. Some of their lettering is so beautiful. And I'm like, well, you need to follow your own advice and you need to, you know, practice that. So I've been thinking about doing that. Maybe because, you know, there's a lot of script fonts. Anyway, so then this is how our door hanger is looking so far. All right. Okay. All right. So let's put this over here. Some of these seeds are a little bit wet. I can still see them. So I'm just drying them up a little bit. So I appreciate y'all hanging out with me on this afternoon as we do some painting for summer. Painting watermelons was one of the, you know, most requested things that I have. Erin says that it's making her want to eat some real watermelon slices. I know. I was thinking as I was drying this, this one needs one more. One more seed. Right there. Okay. All right. Okay. So then, now what I want to do is take my white paint, some more white paint, let's see. And then I just have this one's broken, this brush, and I wanted it to have thinner bristles because I only wanted a few bristles. And so I cut off some of the bristles so it would, let me see. Okay, I got so much paint on here. This is the number 2 liner brush that's in that pack. And so then I just use this to just add some highlights to the seeds. And like I said, the beauty is in the details. Just like that. And then I'm going to add some doodles and stuff. Right here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some puffy paint. I just get this at anywhere that they sell fabric paint, Walmart, Hobby Lobby, Michaels, anywhere. Like I said, that sells puffy paint. Is even on Amazon, I've seen it on there. And so then that is going to be the white of my watermelon slice. So that's what I will do. Hi, Joyce. Hi, Judy. Oh, it took me a second. Joyce said, cayute. I guess she meant cute. I was like, is that code for something? You know, paint has those plastic things. Golly, gotta cut that off. Has those plastic coverings. And some of this was on there pretty tight. Pretty tight. Okay. All right. So, thank you, Joyce. Joyce said it was cute. It took me a second. I was like, C-A-Y-O-O-T. I was like, is that code for something, Joyce? Anyway, again, what I'm using is just puffy paint that I picked up from one of the stores. Anyway, I just make sure that, yeah, that it's going out. And so then I just go around just like that. Just like that. That's how I make my watermelon slice. That is how I do it. Put this one over here so we don't knock it. All right. Thanks for hanging out with me this afternoon, guys. I'm just painting up some watermelon slices that can be used for many, many different things. You could, you know, put them on your tiered tray. You can put them, you know, in just different decorations around your home. I've even put them in adobo or maybe something else that I'm not, you know, thinking about. I'm going to be using these as decorations, embellishments for some country wreaths that I do design for a local business. And so that's what I'm going to be using mine for. But, you know, everyone has different thoughts, different perception. One of my former supervisors is the one who taught me, you know, he said, your perception is your reality. And boy, is that true. Everyone's perception is their reality. And so I was reading actually some stuff earlier that how people just misinterpret, you know, just different, just in general, nothing, you know, really as like, really? They just kind of like, I did not take that, how they just kind of bash other people and interpret things wrong and have to feel like they have to tell them how they shouldn't feel that way. We've all seen that. Just being on social media, you know, you kind of get that. And so, anyway. So then that is how our little watermelon slices. Joyce suggests use them to put your silverware on at each place setting for a picnic. How wonderful. So that's one of the things, guys, you know, look in the comments because sometimes people watching the video will leave different comments and suggestions and just different ideas. And I'm like, oh my goodness, I never thought about that. What a wonderful idea. So I'm just using some puffy paint to, you know, just put on my white of my watermelons, just like that. And as you can see, as I squiggled that on, it ain't perfect. It's not perfect and it's not even, and that's okay because I don't want it to be even. So, you know, just like that. Now, puffy paint does take a while to dry. So I will, like, you know, probably let them dry overnight and that kind of thing. All right. So I didn't put my seeds on here because I didn't know how I was going to do that. And so then probably what I'll do is... Like I said, I like to just do it with black marker first. That's just my personal preference. And since this is a little bit bigger, I think I may put some of the seeds, kind of mix them up, different sizes. And that kind of thing. Brenda says, real watermelons aren't perfect and they are all different. You are so right. And thank you so much for saying that, sweet friend. Yes, you are so right. All right, so then I just have my little round brush and I'm just going to do some more of this. Just fill these holes in. So a couple weeks ago, I had put out a request or a question to, you know, to ask on these craft and chat sessions. I'm trying to do those at least once a week. I want to, you know, maybe work up to a few more where I craft with you real time, like when I'm doing a craft and you can, as long as I'm live, you can chat with me. You can always leave me a comment question after the time. After I'm live, and I always try to, I read every single comment, and I also try to respond, acknowledge in some kind of way by liking it, hearting it, you know, some kind of way, answering any questions that I do get, because, you know, it's, people watch, see the videos at different times, you know, I still get questions on videos that I've done from years ago. I just answered a question on crackle paint on a video that I did a few years ago. So, you know, it just really depends on when it comes up on people's feed and all of that kind of thing. Oh my goodness, that's turning out adorable. 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 Alrighty, let's see. So we're gonna, I just love to add doodles and squiggles and happy dots and all of that stuff to my painted projects. And they are not perfect. And I say that humbly. I don't say that to be like, you know, being less than or anything, but it's just kind of like, I just want to share with people, if you want to learn how to do this, this is what I do. You know, it's a great way to, you know, hang out with me and kind of get to know me. I think I'm going to put a little bit, since this is a bigger one, I'm just going to add a little doodles here before I put that other white on. And I need to wait until my seeds dry so that I can put some white in there. And sometimes, you know, I just have so many like steps to my projects. I put so much stuff into it. Sometimes I'm like, you need to not put so much stuff into it. But I don't know, that's just what I like to do. You know, I just feel like it's missing something. Because then I have to add my paint splatter. Yeah, every single one of those seeds are different. And if, you know, if you as the creator are OCD and you want every single one perfect, you know, you could draw you out a little pattern and, you know, that kind of thing, so that, you know, they would be perfect. But mine are not perfect. They're just more whimsical and all of that stuff. I can't believe that Memorial Day weekend is this weekend. It is just, May is just gone by so fast. My boys, it is their last few days of school. They have to go all the way to Friday. Well, they only have a half a day on Friday. And so then my life is going to change next week because I'm used to being home by myself during the day. I'm not used to having those kiddos around. So it's going to have to readjust, you know, just my mind, just get my mind and you know, just to get my mind in it. All right, so then let me see here. So then just kind of to make my letters pop a bit, sometimes what I'll do is I'll go in the, sometimes I'll put some highlight around, but then sometimes I'll go in the dot and kind of, you know, just give it a little swoosh in the dot of the letter. Just to kind of, you know, enhance it a bit, just to kind of make it pop. And I'm just using, this is my number 2 liner brush that the handle broke a little bit. And so I cut out some of the bristles so that I could get really, really thin. And so that's an idea for you if you're needing a thin brush that, you know, just cut out some of the bristles. That's exactly what I did. Just cut some of them out. Anyway, so that kind of does that. So then now for this one, I'm going to use that puffy paint. I don't know, it's just a habit. I just kind of like make sure that it's flowing. Just do it, you know, on my paint plate or whatever. Anyway, so then I just go and just make a squiggly line that represents the white part of the watermelon. Oh, Linda Ullman is the Faith Chick 777 on YouTube. Guys, y'all have heard me mention Faith Chick 777 before. She is saying that she adds so many steps to her videos and she's always afraid because people will walk off. But it is her style, girl. Stay true to yourself, sweet friends. Stay true to yourself. Your true followers will stay with you. Anyway, guys, this is what I'm doing. Actually what I did with this one is I took the puffy paint and I went all around it. So, you know, depending on what I'm doing will depend on what I, you know, how I kind of do it. So I'm just sharing that just for inspiration purposes, because you can add, you know, more puffy paint around it if you want. You could just put the white doodling around it. That's kind of thing. Thank you, Joyce. But Linda, yes, girl, you stay true to yourself. And we will be here with you. Like I said, if you're watching on the replay, you can always fast forward. You can rewind it to say, what did she say? Or what does she do? What color does she do? Let me just review real quick. This is the red I used. The primary red and the green, the holly green. I just used white paint to do the doodling. For the stripes, I just used this citron green. It's Americana. That's just my preference. And then just my white, the puffy paint. I used that as well. And this is what I used. I used one of these flags that you can get at the Dollar Tree. So now what I'm doing is I need to add my paint splatters because that is what I like to do. And so I'm just using my stiff brush. Now again, the reason that I share this every single time is because I get some horror stories that tell me, you know, that they messed up their carpet or they messed up their table. Make sure your area is covered. And I just use a brush and I go one time over the bristles. It projects onto my painted projects. I just do it one time toward my body. And so I've been doing it for so many years that I know kind of how to guide it as I go along my projects. And as you can see, that little big glump right there just, you know, just glumped out. And it's going to depend on the day, depending on how it wants to come off the brush and how much I have on there. I usually do black first, and then I go back over it with white because I like my white to be on top. So that's just a personal preference. And so usually I just reuse my sticks. The paint's dry, you know, so yeah, see that got a little heavy right there. That's okay. That just adds to the beauty of the project. I know this is old school, but I love this so much. I just love this look. It's just the country girl in me. And so anyway, now I do like to, once this is all dry, because this will take a little time for the puffy paint to dry. This is the sealer I like. This is just a personal preference. I just like the glossy varnish. I do have this one linked in my Amazon shop as well, because I do get questions. So that's why I always repeat myself, because I do get those common questions. What do you use? Where do you recommend? That kind of thing anyway. So this is going to go on a wreath that says Sweet Summer. This is the watermelon. Linda says, is there a faint button? You're funny, girl. Look at that. I just put my finger in there. That is okay, because if that happens, guess what? We just take some paint. Well, you know what I'm going to do? Look at that. I put my finger in there. What I'll do, I'm going to let that dry. I'm going to let it dry. Let me see if I can get a baby wipe. And that's one of the things that I like for these paint and, craft and chat sessions is I paint with you in real time, or craft with you in real time. Yeah, I just totally messed that up. So what I'll do, guys, this is how I will fix that. I'll let it completely dry because I just totally messed that up. And so then I'll just put some red paint over it. And if it still looks a little funky, then I will re-put my paint splatters on it as well. So anyway, that's what I do. Yeah, I totally messed that up. Look at that. That looks horrible. But you know what? I'm going to fix it. I'm going to do the same thing that I share with my community to say, this is what you do. It's only paint. You can just paint over it and stuff. So anyway, I love the way this turned out. Oh my goodness. Oh, and then also what I was going to, I'm going to put this, and I'm just getting myself in this paint. I just stuck my finger in that. That's okay. I'm not going to pick this up anymore. I'm not going to pick it up anymore. If you wanted to, you could, you know, paint this like this, and you could use it, have it for a door hanger, you know, for, you know, you could put like a cute ribbon hanger on it, make a cute bow. If you were like me and got off a little bit as far as like the sweet and then the summer, the R came up over here. I don't want to put my finger in the white paint. You could put a bow right here. That's what I would recommend, like on this side right here. And then it all looks even. And so I just share with you kind of tips that I've learned along the way. My stuff is not perfect. And so I just love to share these gifts and talents that the Lord has given to me to share them with my community. All right. So anyway, like I said, if you have any questions, so Wendy suggests put a seed in the smudge. Great idea. Wonderful idea. Thank you so much for that suggestion. I could definitely do that. She suggested put a seed in the smudge. I could definitely do that. It's a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful idea. I didn't even think about that. So like I said, if you're watching on the replay, you know, skim through the comments, because my community is wonderful of offering different suggestions and different ideas that I didn't even think about. All right. Thanks for watching on this craft and chat session. If you're watching on the replay, please let me know. And we will talk to y'all soon. Y'all, God bless you. We all have a great day, and we'll talk to y'all soon. See you in the next video.